Today, let's take a look at a common task you might have already come across, which is to combine multiple Excel files into one file. So for example, let's say you sent out a template to your colleagues to collect some data. You got them in separate files. Now you want to combine them. Basically, you want to consolidate or append the data in one single file. One solution has always been VBA, but this time we're going to use a simpler approach. We're going to use get and transform, also known as Power Query, from the data tab. My aim is to combine the data from these files by directly connecting to the folder. Now, there are a few requirements. I don't want to include any files that don't have underscore data in it, and I also want to be sure to exclude any non-Excel files. Let's quickly take a look at the content of the files. I have sales information for a specific month. The data is not in an Excel table. The structure of the files, though, are identical. They all have identical headers. Now, I want to make sure I exclude this file. Now, what I want my end result to be is a pivot table that combines the data from these files. I want to get a summarized sales report by company and customer. Let's open a blank workbook, go to data, get data from file, from folder. Browse for the folder. My files are sitting right here, okay and okay. Now Power Query goes ahead, creates a connection to the folder and checks what's inside that folder. If all the data was in a proper format, if it only included the files that I need, I could go ahead and combine and load the data directly to the workbook. But I need to make some transformations on this. So let's go ahead and transform the data. Before I combine these files, which we can see right here, what I want to do is to filter out the files that I don't need. So I said that I don't need anything that doesn't have underscore data. So for text filters, I want to include everything that contains underscore data and okay. I also want to make sure I've restricted everything to Excel files, begins with .xls and okay. Those are my two steps. Now I'm ready to go ahead and combine the content. All I have to do is click on this double down arrow, combine files, and Power Query is going to bring up the navigator asking me which tab or which data I want to combine. The decision I make here is based on a sample file. So it's picked the first file, which is Barraclyde in that folder. From this first file, I get to pick the tab that I want. And let's go with OK. Now Power Query is going to go and try to figure out what transformation it should apply to that sample file, apply that transformation to all the other files, and append the data. This is all the work that it's done for me. Now, unfortunately, at this point, it's not perfect because my data wasn't in perfect Excel tables. So I need to make some adjustments, but it's gone ahead and added all these steps. My last step before I click this button was this step. What it did is it added another filter. It filtered the hidden files. So if I happen to have one of these files open in the background, I'm not going to run into problems. It's going to be automatically filtered. Then it went ahead and created all these transformations, which is not that much here. It tried to figure out what it should do to that sample file to get it in a proper format so that it can apply that to all the other files before it appends them together. The function here takes this transformation and rolls it out to other files before it combines it here. That's what this step means. Then it went ahead and decided to rename this column to source.name. And then it removed all the other information about the file, and then it expanded our data and it applied a change type. So now we know we need to clean this before we load, but where do we do the cleaning? Do we clean the appended version or do we clean the sample version? Now it's up to you, but wherever possible, try to do the cleanup on the sample file level before Power Query appends them together. Now, some steps, though, you need to do on the appended level, because only on the appended level do I have the file name, which I could actually use to grab the company name. So if I go back a step, before we expanded the table, I could actually take care of that right after this. I could also take care of it in the end here. In my case, I'm going to take care of it here. So I'm going to rename this to company, insert a step, and I'm also going to extract the company name from the file name. Transform, extract, text before delimiter. My delimiter is an underscore, but I'm just going to add underscore data to this and go with OK. Now, once it expands it, I have the correct company name expanded. Now, because my header changed, the change type step doesn't apply, I'm actually going to exit out because it doesn't make sense to apply change type to these. I should clean these before. Let's take a quick look at the cleaning we need to do. First off, the column headers are repeated. And second, we have a bunch of null rows at the bottom of some of the datasets here. Let's clean that by cleaning the sample. Inside the sample file, I don't need the promoted headers there. What I actually need to do is to remove the top two rows. Remove top rows, put a 2 and OK. Now I want to promote the headers here. So use first row as headers. And next, I want to take care of these null rows. So remove rows, remove blank rows. Now, another thing it did automatically when I promoted the headers is it decided to change the type. That doesn't really help me though in the append side because I still need to do the type here. So what I prefer to do is remove the change type step from here and get that correct in the last step here. So I'm just going to press Ctrl A to select everything, transform, detect data type, and just double check that everything is correct. Okay, I have clean data. Let's go and load this as a pivot table. So close and load 2, pivot table report. Let's just put it on the existing sheet here and okay. Now let's analyze the sales values by customer and company. Let me just update the design here to show in tabular format. This way I can see the total sales by each company to the customers and see which ones are selling to the same customer. Now let's say I get new data. Lucas Basics here decides to send their data, so I'm going to grab the file and drop it here. They've input the data, they just have put the columns in a different order. So sales value is no longer in the end, it's in the E column instead of where the other ones have it, which is the F column. Is that going to give us problems? Let's check. Let's go, right mouse click, and refresh. We have Lucas Basics data right here. The order of columns doesn't matter. What matters is to have identical column headers. Because check this out, if I open Lucas Basics data and instead of sales value S with a capital S, I have a small s, I'm just going to save this, and let's go back here and refresh, the data is not going to show up. Now for problems such as this, you need to decide where you want to do the cleanup. Do you want to clean up the source file? Or is this a common problem that some headers could be capitalized, some headers aren't? Is this something you want to take care of in the Power Query side? If you decide to take care of it on the Power Query side, you could add a new step and capitalize all the headers before you combine them. But to do that, you need to be familiar with M functions. This is something we're going to cover in the advanced section of the course. If you're interested to find out more about my Power Query course, check out the description below this video. Now, what if you wanted your end result to be a table instead of a pivot table? Well, all you have to do is change the load destination. Right mouse click on the final query, load 2, select table instead of pivot table, existing worksheet A1 is fine, and click on OK. It's asking us if we really want to remove this pivot table. We do, and that's our table. All the data appended below one another. So that's how you can use Excel's Get and Transform feature to combine data from multiple files into one file. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. And if you like what you see, consider subscribing to this channel if you haven't done so already. And don't forget to hit that bell so you get updates when new videos come out here. And I'll see you in the next video.